So let's continue with the discussion. We were to discuss about the general form of do while loop, how to write a do while loop. Then we will come for the for loop, okay? Because I will have to show the difference between do while and while. So unlike for and while loop, which takes the loop condition at the top of the loop, the do while loop in C programming language takes its condition at the bottom of the loop. The difference bujhte parle? Do while loop in C programming language checks its condition at the bottom of the loop. And the do while loop is similar to while loop, except that do while loop is guaranteed to execute at least one time. This is very, very important. This statement is very, very important. It represents the fact that the difference between do while and while loop, or you can say it represents the fact that why do while loop is inefficient or it has a limitations that we cannot use do while loop in each and every places. Because in case of do while loop, unlike for loop and while loop, in case of do while loop, it's guaranteed to execute at least one time. At least one time the do while loop must execute, while where the while loop and for loop doesn't execute. Let's check it out. Let me give you one example. Your conception will be clear. Okay. So how to write a do while loop? Very simple. First, we will do the initialization operation. First, we will do the initialization operation, right? Then write the do statement. Then write the do statement. Do not use any semicolon after do. Now within the do statement, after the do statement, you will give a open brace and close brace. That means loop should be given after the do statement. Within the do statement, within this open brace and close brace, you will have to write the body of the loop. That means the statements which are going to be executed, and increment or decrement operations, right? Any one of it as per your development, right? Now you will write the while loop where the do close brace has been ended, and that while condition should be ended with a semicolon. The while condition must be ended with a semicolon. It's very important. This semicolon must be placed at the end of do while loop. That means at the end of the while condition of the do while loop. That is mandatory. Don't forget to give it. Okay, this is the syntax of do while loop. That means the conditions of the do while loop must be ended with a semicolon. This is the overall structure or general structure of do while loop. Now, can we implement the same code in the form of do while loop? Can we implement the same code in the form of do while loop? Yes, we can. So first, initialization is equivalent to this. Then we will just cut it down and write do. Okay. And here we'll write the condition with ending semicolon bracket, right? The similar thing. Now we will execute this code. Okay, the hello world is again printed 4 times, just like the previous while loop, right? So do while loop, I think the conception will be clear to everyone, how we can write a do while loop. What is the general syntax of do while loop? Or how we different from the while loop, right? Now let me tell you the most important logic, or you can say the limitation or drawback of any do while loop. So it will represent this fact that do while loop, unlike for loop or while loop, do while loop is guaranteed to execute at least one time, or at least one statement, or one time the body of the loop. At least one time the body of the loop. What does it mean? Try to understand. Let's take out the previous one. I equal to 0. I greater than equal to 0. Now, can anyone tell me how many times the loop will be executed? How many times this loop will be executed? How many times?
One time.
It doesn't execute even a single time. Akbar is good, Urbana. Why? Because it will never enter into this because condition. Because equal to zero is there. Okay, equal to zero is there. Obviously, it will not enter into the loop at least one condition. Right? So, after...
I is equal to zero, you know, to Akbar, two.
Yes. Sorry. One second. I equal to zero. So, in that case, the loop will not execute, right? Urbeki? Let's check it out.
No, sir.
Okay. But I equal to zero, on, sorry, for one time it will execute. আচ্ছা ওয়ান থিং উই উইল ডু
ইয়েস জিরো তো হবে
লেস দ্যান ইকুয়াল টু জিরো ইন দিস কেস দ্য লুপ উইল নট এক্সিকিউট এট আ সিঙ্গেল অ্যামাউন্ট অফ টাইম তাও ইকুয়াল টু হচ্ছে আচ্ছা ইকুয়াল টু জিরো আছে তো
ওয়ান স্যার লেস দ্যান ইকুয়াল টু আছে তো ইকুয়াল টু জন্য তো একবার হবে
ইয়েস ইয়েস ইকুয়াল টু জন্য একবার হবে
এবার হবেই না এবার আউটপুট বেরোবেই না এবার
ঠিক আছে দ্যাট ইজ নো আউটপুট বিকজ আই লেস দ্যান জিরো ইজ গিভেন নাও দ্য সেম কোড আই এম রাইটিং উইথ দ্য হেল্প অফ ডু ওয়াইল ডু just making it copy paste just same code follow kore dekho syntax of do while loop I think everyone agree with me only these things need to be changed the rest of the syntax is similar understood do while loop will execute this hello world statement at once ekbar execute korche whereas in case of while loop if we write the same condition for while loop it doesn't execute the hello world statement at any single point of time that is the difference of do while loop and while loop bujhte pachho this is the example that you will have to show or any example as per your choice this is one of the example that I am showing to you that represent the difference between do while loop and while loop so what it actually working how it actually working try to understand when i equal to 0 the control enters in the do loop because here the condition does not check so first it will print this hello world statement right because there is no condition has been given here so control simply print the hello world statement and then the value of I becomes plus plus and then it will check the condition whether the I is less than 0 so I becomes 1 right now so 1 is not less than 0 it doesn't satisfy the condition so it will terminate the loop but at least one time this hello world statement will be executed why because at starting the condition has not been given in case of do while loop the condition has been given at the end of this loop so that's why this thing has been told to you that in do while loop is guaranteed to execute at least one time mane ekbar ei loop ta execute korbei why because the condition statement has been written or has been mentioned at the end of the execution of the loop so at least one time that loop will be executed but in case of while loop if you see the structure of the while loop this is the while loop structure of the same statement here it will not allow to enter even a single amount of time why because at the first statement it will check the condition prothome condition ta check korche and if the condition fails the checking condition fails so it will never allow you to enter into the while loop or even it will not print a single amount of time of this body of the loop so it will simply execute from the loop clear anyone has any doubt any question is very very important this difference is very very important any question any doubt is it clear to you is it crystal clear
yes sir
ekdom porishkar prottekey the question will ask in the interview or the question will come in the in your exam multiple amount of time very frequently okay so you will have to give the answer with this code snippet I again tell to everyone I already told it in my previous classes you will have to choose those questions where you are able to give some code proof or you can say some sort of code snippet means some portion of a code snippet means portion of a code okay so where you can justify your logic with the help of some code or some program just choose the question into your exam accordingly okay don't choose try to avoid if you have the options to choose try to avoid to choose a theoretical questions because it will never carry the full mark okay and if you want a good mark in C programming you will have to choose such a question where we can give any kind of code or even a code snippet okay and whatever code you are going to give please explain that code with your own terms jera koi mukhe bolchi you have to write that code explanation okay without explanation the code has no meaning to give into your exam exam e likhle tumi sir sob jane sir bujhe nebe then you are wrong okay I am deducting some marks because you didn't have the code explanation remember it very carefully now I will show you the last form of the looping that is the for loop how we can define a for loop very simple to define a for loop we'll have to use this keyword for and till now we have already used multiple keywords do while, and for. These three keywords we have used to represent a loop, and all these three keywords among 32 keywords in C programming language. Okay. So for loop, within for loop, again, we are giving the same three conditions: initialization, condition checking, and increment or decrement operation. So within the for loop, how we can give it? Initialization. We'll give initialization in such a way. Then we will give condition checking. Okay. Then semicolon. Then we will give increment or decrement. Okay. Now we will give the body of the for loop, or you can say the body of the loop or body of the statement which are going to be executed. Okay. This is a very generous form of declaration of a for loop, or you can say the most general form or most popular form of declaring or using a for loop. There are several forms that exist in the market. I will show you all the forms, but this is one of the general form of declaring a for loop or writing a for loop. So for initialization, condition checking, and increment decrement. And please remember that each and every component will be separated by a semicolon. Each and every component within a for loop, within this parentheses, must be separated by a semicolon. Okay. And there should not be any semicolon at the end of the for loop. But within these internal components, all the components are separated from each other with a semicolon. Clear? So if I am going to write the code, this code, which I have already shown to you, okay, in case of while loop, that means this hello world will be executed 4 times within the form of for loop. How we can write it? Very simple. For loop, initialization here we will do I equal to 0. Clear? Here you can also mention int I is your choice, or you can declare the int I at the top of the program. Right? Now, condition checking. What is the condition I have given? I less than equal to 3. And then increment operation I am using here. So I plus plus. This is the for loop. Achha, again, the same concept is there. If there is only one statement, you don't need to use the loop brackets here. If there is one, just like the if else, I have already told. If there is any one statement as a block of the, as a body of the loop, then you don't need to use any open brace or close brace to enclose that particular statement. If there are more than one statement, then you must have to use this open brace and close brace. For all kinds of loops, while loop, do while loop, and for loop, it will follow the same concept. Okay. Now, we'll just omit this one. We don't require while loop. So this is a for loop. Run it. Clear? Anyone has any doubt regarding this? Is it clear, everyone?
Yes, after sir. This,
clear? Please practice it at your home. Now I will show you some of the interesting forms of the for loop, or various forms of the for loop. Okay, then I will close down this session. So the first form, I equal to 0. Okay, we can skip this one and we can write here in this way. This is one form of the for loop. Try to understand. Try to catch what I am trying to show you. Int I equal to 0 is the initialization of the variable which I have declared or which I have initialized at the first statement of the main method. Now within for loop, I just left that initialization part blank. I just left the initialization part blank. And rest of the part, I will have it. So this will also work. Why I'm showing these codes to you? When porikkhar somoy jokhon tomake output find korte debe or in your gate examination, they can use any one of these for loop forms to ask you the question for output finding of the code. And then you will ask, sir, you didn't show me these are the various forms are there. Okay, so you are getting confused. So that's why I'm showing these things, right? Now the second one. This is also possible. Okay. That means I omit the initialization part and increment decrement part, and increment part I've written within the for loop after the printf statement, just like the while loop, and initialization was already earlier there. Same output you will receive. Clear? Everyone clear? Anyone has any doubt?
Yes, sir.
So this is another way of writing a, that means increment part you are not using, only the initialization and that condition checking part you are showing here. Okay. Now, multiple condition checking you can also perform here. Multiple condition checking you are also allowed to perform here. Multiple condition checking means suppose I less than equal to 3 and I less than equal to 4. Jara kichu kon age tomake while loop e khetre dekhalam. I less than equal to 4. Okay. So you are going to print %d space %d comma I comma j. And here it should be j equal to 0. The 1 kore di. 1 right. And here it should be comma d j plus plus. So here you can apply the logical or logical and conditions in such a way, just like the while loop. And here you can also implement multiple initialization in such a way by using comma. You cannot use semicolon here.
It should be not j, sir. J less than equal to 4.
Oh, sorry, sir. Yes, j.
You write both I, both.
J less than equal. J undeclared, sorry, sir. J should be declared. Okay. Clear? Everyone clear? Okay, so in such a way this is called a for loop with multiple initialization and multiple increment operations within the same for loop, or you can say more than one conditions are joined with the help of logical operator or logical operations. So these are the various kinds of for loop. Apart from these, there are one more for loop is available, that is called nested for loop. How you can define nested for loop? Very simple. Within for loop, there should be another for loop. That's called just like nested if loop. Nested for loop is also there, but nested for loop has a good implementation, has a very popular implementation, unlike nested if. Nested if is a implementation ami bound koreji korar jonno, but nested for loop has more implementation, okay? Has a very popular implementation. So j, I less than equal to 3 is the first for loop. Is for I, the loop variable is I, and second for loop, the loop variable is j, okay? And then it will print I or j, whatever you will fail to print, okay? Okay, in this way we can do it. And I will show you the use of nested for loop. I will show you the use of nested for loop while we are printing patterns. Several sort of pattern printing is a very, very, very important and popular program in C. Okay, pattern printing. I will give you several patterns and you will have to print with the help of C programming like this. Suppose I'm asking you to write a C program to print this pattern. It is a star pattern looking like a rectangle, okay, looking like a rectangle which has a 90 degree, okay, ki rectangle jeno bole bhule gechi. What is the name of this rectangle? Bolo, right angle rectangle,
right? Triangle.
So this is called a right angle triangle whose angle is actually 90 degree, right? This one is 90 degree. So I am actually trying to ask you a question that you are going to write a C program to print this pattern. Okay, and you have to logically print this pattern. That means you cannot print this pattern with the help of printf only. That means printf star, then new line, then the next line printf to two times you will print star, then new line, then in the next line three times you will printf star. You cannot do in such a way. Why? Because you don't know how many star as a user you can give as an input. Okay, so In runtime, you can give multiple stars or multiple line as an input. So you have to write your program logically. And in such kind of patterns, not only star patterns, we can also go for the character patterns print or number pattern prints. So any pattern can come into the exam. And there you are going to use the help of nested for loops. Two for loops or more than two for loops can also be used. Three for loops can also be used. Okay. And not only that, while I am going to discuss about the array representation in future, array representation, here I will also show you the use of a nested for loop. In case of 2D array, I will show you the 2D array or multi-dimensional array. I will show you the use of nested for loop. So these are the two very, very important use of nested for loop. Okay. So anyone has any question? Anyone has any question? I will stop my session here for today.
No, sir.
Is it clearly understood? Bolo?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I have question regarding what's the...
Haan, haan, bolo.
Bolo, bolo.